What is up, Robbie? How are you? Oi, Phil, too. Hell yeah. We in here already, boys? I'm just like setting up the tabs and stuff so that I can like just get to stuff easy. How is everybody today on this nice little Sunday? It was okay looking before. It's a little nicer now. Oh, I'm feeling so much better today, Robbie. Like I am rested. I finally got like a good night's sleep. Me and Meredith both actually. We are kind of like finally figured out how to move forward in a way that's like not gonna be insane. And now we're just like in the production mode. Now we are drawing pages, and that's all I'm gonna do for the next month. The excitement of the last 3 days has just been wild, but the fun has come to an end. Now we got a book to make. Just gonna pin this up there. Or maybe I should actually do like, how do I get rid of comments? Nice. What's it called? Oh, nice. So I had to look up just for the proper wording of giant size to be used. I think a comic needs to be at least 80 pages, and since I don't have 80 pages of actual comics, I don't want to call this issue giant sized. But I am thinking that issue 2 is going to be, say giant size on it. I'm going for 80 pages. For the next one. This is down the line. We're gonna be here for now. So I'm just since we're on the top, since I saw 80 page book in your message, that's just reminded me of that. But let me get the Kickstarter onto the stream. screen real quick, and then we'll get going. The fuck is this? It's not the tab I chose at all. God damn it. Ooh, this is making me mad. Why? Why is it not letting me pick this fucking tab? Jesus, thank you. Holy cow, that is awfully annoying. I don't even know if you guys can fucking see that, but it's up there. Whatever. Alright. There you go. Enjoy. We can see. Okay, good. Good, 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 good. I can't see it for shit. Unfortunately, I don't have, like, the bandwidth or upload rates to watch my own stream at a good quality or very large, so I can't really tell what's going on most times. Done. And then this one. And then this one. Nope. Yeah, that's the one I want to see. Okay, good. Perfect. This is good. Okay, that's pretty good. I've got the screen mostly in there. Give myself a little bit more room today. Alright guys, so the plan, we sort of had a little huddle, me and Meredith, and decided how we need to kind of move forward so that this can get rolling with like updates and all sorts of stuff. So we're going to try to lock down these pages that I've been working on basically for the last week. Pretty like this page is more or less done, this one down here. So we're gonna lock down, we're gonna try and like do this, this pan, no, not this panel, this panel that I've been kind of sitting on for a minute, and these pages are basically done. I'm just like adding extra detail because I want to when I really just need to kind of finish, so I'm gonna do that. Thanks, Robbie. I think I can too. I'm gonna pull a maybe a later night tonight, so that I can make sure that I finish if I need to. But then tomorrow we'll start on the next batch of pages and basically work up groups of pages together. Meredith bought a couple organizing bins for me. Now I've got a little bit of organization. Let's go. Oh, great. Me and Meredith kind of did all the marketing stuff you're supposed to do today too. I made like a that post with the Kickstarter image on it, so that I could pin it to my account. Which one of my friends who has successfully funded like multiple campaigns was like, "You need to do this like immediately." So I did that, and we boosted the post, which I guess is like under review or whatever. So we'll hear back, not 1 to 3 days, 24 hours was what they told us. So we'll hear back about that tomorrow. Yeah, exactly. It's like I'm a pro. It's almost like I'm gonna start doing this every 3 months or something, where I'm gonna like make a book and then let you guys buy it, and then make another book and let you guys buy it. It's almost like I'm a professional comic artist. Almost. We're almost there. The organization's getting there. I mean, my pages were a mess. Meredith literally called them the doom pile today. Or was that me? Huh? You called it that. Yeah. Yeah, Meredith called my stack of pages the doom pile. So I'm finishing these pages. What about if we want to put that screen tone on this guy's jacket, or if I want to do a hand-drawn texture? Think we have to make that decision now. Just gonna do it by hand. I don't want to make Meredith like edit multiple pages multiple times, so I'm trying to make these decisions now so that the book editing. If I had more time, this wouldn't be an issue. But I don't. So we're all like kind of needing to put the finished product down as soon as it's ready and call it done and not go back to it. That's really hard for me sometimes. So it's a challenge, but we're gonna try. We're gonna try to do that. We went and tried to like, we're having our wedding ceremony in November, and Bed Bath & Beyond is like going out of business, and so we went there today to kind of like just walk around and get some stuff that we needed around the house for a little cheaper, and maybe see what we could like maybe need for the future, for like a wedding registry or something and all that. So we went out there, got a little sunshine, bought a few things, got some cheaper like sheets for our bed, like to get an have an extra set or whatever, and yeah. Then I got home. Oh shit, that is
Well, that's a little bit much.
Hey, thanks. Yeah, it's kind of like a home goods store in America. That's wild that you don't have American comics where you're at, dude. Or like Western comics, like you're saying. Probably a better term for them. Huh? Manga, actually. Manga is what he's saying he has most of down there. Yeah, that is super interesting. French comics, maybe? Yeah, like the European stuff. Yeah, we did, Phil. Unfortunately, today's Sunday, and we have a place that we want to go to do it, and so we're gonna actually go tomorrow or at some point in the day, next day or two, and get that set up. We just need to like call them and figure out like what documentation we need to take to open one and all that before we go. But yeah, we're doing that tomorrow. We did talk about it. You reminded us about it yesterday when we were on stream last night, and I actually remembered, surprisingly, to bring it up. We have been meaning to do it. I told him that last night. For the same reason, as I stated before, we're having the marriage thing going, and like maybe the people that don't want to necessarily come to Savannah or whatever, still want to send us something. It's just easier in case we're not at the house or whatever. It's kind of essential in our line of work, especially since we travel for shows and all that stuff. It's just the best option. Hey, I actually do want to do the Houndstooth. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that later tonight. Let's see how that looks later tonight. Let's do this. Probably about when my Kickstarter campaign hit $3,000 is when I realized I was mega awesome. Robbie, to answer your question. Or at least that's, you know. It helped. What am I doing? What was I doing? Oh, right. I was looking something up. Come on. I'm trying to find a reference for this fucking character, but I guess he did it so long ago. You trying to talk to me? What's up? Okay. Hold on. What's up, Chauncey? I gotta mute my mic because Meredith is gonna use a hairdryer. What would you like me to ask the chat, Meredith? What should we name? Me and Meredith went to Home Depot today. Savannah is kind of a humid place, and in the summer, it's kind of very easy to get, like, kind of fruit flies and things coming, tracking into the house when you open the door. It's, like, a little miserable sometimes, but it's manageable. And we usually do, like, vinegar traps and that sort of thing, but we went to Home Depot today on our excursion into the sun today, and picked up some Venus fly traps, and Meredith wants to know what you think we should name them. It's like a bunch of them in like one little pot, so I think it's like a kind of a hydra situation. So it's like one plant with many heads. If that helps you with your name. No, just one name for the plant. We're considering it one plant. I said it had a lot of heads because, I don't know, would you regularly name something with a lot of heads the same thing you would name something with one head? Like, you can't call a Hydra Greg, you know? Listen, in my headcanon,
I know they look like mouths.
Those are heads, okay?
I know they look like mouths.
In my headcanon, Venus flytraps are a bunch of little heads just snatching flies out of the air. Oh, that means you're an artist, dude. You're one of my artist friends that comes to this channel. What? Would you like to not be distinguished as an artist in this channel? Because that would just be inaccuracies, bro. How are people supposed to know what's going on? What's up, Matt Houghton? I don't know what it does for you, Chauncey. I think it just puts you guys in a category that I can maybe make you guys extra emoticons and stuff for. But since you know, make art on a regular basis, I consider you an artist, and so here you are. Yeah, Matt D. Houghton, I am fairly certain that you backed the Kickstarter today. I really, really appreciate that. Just checking the list. Hey, nice. Hey, I have a weird name. Thank you. Thank you so much, Matt. Really appreciate it. I have a weird name too, and my favorite streamer says that my name is stupid every time I come up on his channel, so I know what it's like. I had a history teacher in high school who called me Alpo, like the dog food. Nice. Thank you very much, Chauncey. I really appreciate it. I have some really great friends, apparently. Trying to get all the references I want to get in here so that I can just call this page done, so that we can move forward in the campaign. We're trying to lock down 6 pages today, guys. A lot of it is already done, but there is still a lot of work to get done to get all 6 pages classified as finished into the binder, or to the scanners rather. Oh no, I'm just taking photos of this so that I can send it to like the people I'm referencing, just to make sure that they're, you know, cool with me throwing their artwork, you know, their stuff into the book. Thank you, Matt. Thanks a lot, man. I'm just trying to get the last few little details in. Just want to make a couple more little references, and then I'll feel good about moving on to more pages where there will be more references, but like the first page kind of has to give you like a Where's Waldo almost effects. Is kind of what I want out of it anyway. Thanks, Robbie. like midnight, so I'm going to get off. Got some jobs to do tomorrow. I hope everything goes well, and see you tomorrow if you're streaming. I will be basically, I'm in the working stage, Robbie, so I'm going to be streaming basically every day until this book is done. So have a good day at work tomorrow. Thank you so much for being here. Thanks for everything. Hey, Matt, thanks so much for the follow. Robbie, have a good night, man. Get some sleep. Get some rest. You got a lot. You're going to need a lot of energy for those pages tomorrow, so. Damn, Robbie is 6 hours ahead of us. Damn. Wait, what was the question? What was this? I'm sorry, man, I missed it. Hold on. Question. As an artist and say you dig Jim Lee, which is better, trying to draw better than Lee's first published work, that Santa Claus book, or better than his most famous Uncanny X-Men or Hush? I mean, I think that's probably the healthiest way to think about it, Phil, but I don't think you should ever get caught up in trying to draw like any one person. I had this conversation like actually multiple times this weekend because Meredith was tabling at a little free comic book day signing event, and
sorry, Tony McMillan just got back to me, the creator of Attaboy. I'm gonna finish my point. I'm not gonna forget. I just need to respond to him real quick. Let's hang. Okay, great. So what I was saying before was, don't get caught up. Yeah, Tony is super fire. I love his stuff. It's weird, but you could tell it's like pouring straight out of his heart. He's like not even drawing with his hands. It's really, really cool stuff. Yeah, thanks, Phil. So what I was saying before was I wouldn't get caught up in trying to draw like any one person. Style is a trap, guys. If you really want to learn how to draw, you need to learn how to draw. You don't go to school there's no like draw like Jim Lee class, and then next door is draw like Rob Liefeld class, and next door is draw like Ashley Wood class, and then next door Art Adams. Like, it doesn't work that way. You are inspired by everything that you look at, even if it's not even art. You're like absorbing visual vocabulary and things all the time. If you take any time to put a brush to paper or a pencil or anything and try to draw, every single one of those influences is affecting the single line that you're working on. Like, I can draw this line and like without even thinking about it, I'm subconsciously trying to do James Herron, Daniel Warren Johnson, Jack Kirby, Mobius. Like, I'm doing all like your brain is processing so fast and making decisions so quickly that you don't have time to think like, this is my Jim Lee line. Like, it doesn't work that way. You might like Jim Lee and you might think that you're like trying to learn how to draw by copying him, but you're not, because Jim Lee learned how to draw and then became Jim Lee, not the other way around. So when you are drawing and you come to a point where you feel like your style, you should always be comparing to the most modern thing, I guess. I mean, unless you're trying to go for a retro comic or something of that kind. But if you're trying to make a book that's like going to be on modern stands, like with people who are trying to pick it up today, it's got to like, I think, compare to stuff from today. Or else, like, basically you're just saying like, is your style like long box, like back issues, or is it on the shelf when you walk in the door, you know? Like, if you're trying to draw like Jim Lee in 1990 whatever, then okay, that's cool. You must really, really like that one moment in time to spend all your time trying to mimic that one moment. He doesn't even draw like that anymore. And he is Jim Lee. So what does that tell you? Style is always evolving. Jim Lee doesn't even draw like Jim Lee anymore. Jim Lee today isn't Jim Lee from 10 years ago. Yeah, sure, a lot of people are doing that. A great example is Pink Lemonade. Have you guys picked that book? Pink Lemonade looks like a retro, fun, super, just like, it's not about like the muscles and all of that. There are muscles and stuff, but like the way he draws.
do a quick search of Pink Lemonade comic, and then go find the artist. I think it's Nick. God damn it! It's slipping off my fucking brain now. Nick Cagnetti, that's it. Nick Cagnetti. Cagnetti. I'm gonna lower this music on my end for a little bit. It's a little distracting, honestly. Battletoads, though. If you guys didn't recognize it or know. Yeah, Pink Lemonade is that, dude. Like, Pink Lemonade is an old idea of comics done in a new style. Like, taking that old vibe and making it fresh. That's what I get from that book. It's not like, oh man, this guy's doing Jack Kirby. It's like, no, this guy's doing Nick Cagnetti. He's like a new artist. He's a young guy. Que carajo de pasa, chico? What's up, man? Hey guys, give me a second. I need to talk to a friend of mine, Carlos, from back home for a minute, and it's been an hour, so I'm gonna stretch, all right? Give me like 5-10 minutes.
Hey, thank you so much to Noodle Skadoodle for the follow. And Matt Houghton as well. And I don't know who this guy is. Marco LV. Thanks a lot, guys. Noodle Skadoodle is a good friend of mine's son. So it's really special to have him here, guys. Yeah, all right. Yeah, no, I fucking love you guys. Thanks for calling, Carlos. I'm glad. I wasn't sure because since you're on the Patreon, I thought that maybe you were getting the updates and stuff. But yeah, man. Yeah, okay. All right, man. Have a good one. Bye, Chris. Bye. All right, guys. Oh my goodness, day drinking. Downtown? I gotta send a friend of mine that image. Matt Houghton is day drinking today, apparently. He needs to get some food. You need to drink some water, bud, is what you gotta do. Drink some water between drinks. It'll help you drink longer, if you can believe it. It'll help you live longer too.
I might have a drink too. You want to have a drink? You want to have a drink too?
What are you doing over here? Yeah. If you start a little here and there, it's not gonna hurt.
Yeah.
How are you doing it? Are you like doing the finger smacking it, or are you like doing the tap tap? Wearing a glove. All right. Oh, shit. What in the world, bro? What was that?
Editor's Day Portfolio, you have been selected by Marquise Draper. Friday, May 12th at 9:20 a.m. Cool. Friday.
Oh, it's Friday.
Friday, May 12th. Cool. I got a review with a DC editor. I did. And they didn't.
They might not understand it out yet.
Oh, fair enough.
They might not understand it out yet.
All right.
They're really disorganized.
So the email said reviews colon DC.
Yeah.
That was
they
it.
They might send a separate email.
You think so?
Yeah, that's what they did last year.
Yeah, but it seemed like, why would you do that for one person, though? I guess to make it clear exactly who you got selected for in that email.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. Okay, I'll wait. I'll wait before I start throwing people under the bus. I really like Jim Lee. I think he is a formative artist for everybody. Who's ever read American comics probably in our day. I don't know if I'm ever going to be that busy. I don't want to be an editor at DC or editor-in-chief at DC or whatever the fuck position he holds now. So hopefully not. There's a couple more shirts I want to fill in, but... Silva Cora just sent me a message, by the way, which is kind of fucking wild. I'm trying to ignore it so I don't freak out, but you know, that's, I don't even know what it is. Turtle Power. Excuse me. Turtle Power. Did I miss something?
Hello?
Yes? Oh, let me mute the mic. Meredith's going to be using the hair dryer here in a sec. Oh man, Sobukore. Sobukore, playing with my heartstrings. Message me, gave me, they messaged me turtle power with a little turtle emoji. And I was like, cowabunga, like, it's really cool that I'm talking to you right now, but I don't know what you mean by that. Sobukore, please, please understand. I want to know what you're talking about, but I don't. And they mentioned the Discord, Erwin Papa's Discord, and I got invited to do a pinup in the redraw of issue one for the back, I guess, because they didn't have any pages left for me. Unfortunately, I got there a little bit too late, not for any other reason. My heart would have probably exploded if they told me, yeah, here are your two pages of the TMNT1 redraw book we're gonna do. I would have exploded. But anyway, I'm doing a pinup for the back, and Sobukore is messaging me. And they're like, I'm so excited to see your pages. And I was like, wait a second. I get pages? I thought y'all were out of pages. Erwin told me yesterday that they had run out, they had assigned all the pages to everybody. So when Soba said that, I was like, you are kidding me. You've got pages right now for me to do? And he was like, oh, I guess not. I guess we did run out. I was like, oh, that's when I came back on. I was like, oh, this guy. Oh. So good. Soba is amazing. You're listening to me over there. Killing me, Soba. Trying to end the campaign, guys. That's what you're trying to do. Really nice.
Yeah, well, here is the only space.
Yeah, he's probably just watching, like, oh, watch me mess this guy up. Watch me get him real good. Watch me get him real, real good. I'll see it coming. Damn, yo, when did I post that? Three hours ago? Damn. That flew. Mark Laszlo with the sickness. All right. I told Catalan his back cover art is main cover level. Yeah, probably. I mean, his cover for that book is definitely main cover level. For sure. That is, his stuff is quality. Kevin's gonna do real well, I think. Glad I could, like, communicate with him before, you know, he was out in space with his knights. Connecting wraparound covers when? We'll figure it out. I'll talk to him. I think he's going to be at Heroes, so I know he's going to be at Heroes. I think that's like going to be his first show ever. Can you fucking believe that? I think that I could stand next to Kevin artistically, no problem. I think he is fantastic, and I think he and I love big fucking bombastic, super cool, scenic, like, action scenes and stuff. Like, I feel like I already know him. But I wish, like, that, but that's today. I don't think my first Heroes Con I would be able to say that out loud the way that I am right now. I wouldn't even dare. Just like you were saying, Jim Lee back then to Jim Lee now. Victor Alpy back then was not Victor Alpy now. Not even close. Am I muted? No. Okay, good. Really didn't want to fucking go on that diatribe and see that I was muted. That would have been upsetting. Bird Witch with the shout out, yo! Okay, so what are we at on the stream? We've got about 12 minutes. We've got about 12 minutes, guys, to 2 hours, right? And I know this is going to sound crazy coming from me, but I think I'm going to end the stream in 12 minutes. At 2 hours. A measly, just pathetic amount of time. I dragged you out here for nothing. But me and Meredith have to eat dinner. It's almost 8 o'clock, so I'm going to come back after that. And then we're going to do late night stream. All right? I hope that's okay with everybody. I'm going to just kind of focus on this for the next 10 minutes so I can like finish strong. Maybe even put this away, like, right at the end of the stream. So let me, you guys, just keep it down. Talk amongst yourselves for a sec. I really do gotta get this done. And there might actually be some actual focus time, like, I can't even look at the screen and talk to you guys at moments, if I'm gonna get this campaign done. I think there's a lot riding on getting it done. I think all my future Kickstarter success
is heavily, heavily going to need the success and timely, not reimbursement, but the reward fulfillment, you know, a timely reward fulfillment where I get everything out to everybody in a timely manner. Thank you. Yeah, Chauncey, you got you knew where I was going. All of the success of the next Kickstarter is banking on this Kickstarter success. So, like, I need to get this book done. It's not just like, yeah, you're going to get it anyway. It's like, if I am late, then I'm going to probably be late on all of them, you know? Even if it is my first one, there's going to be those people that just, like, get upset about it. And I just don't want those people to exist. Like, I don't want anyone to have that, like, out when judging my work. If you don't like it, that's fine. I respect that. But if you're just going to be upset because and shit on me because you got your Kickstarter a week or two later than I promised, then, I mean, I kind of don't even want you here to begin with. Like, you can refund your own fucking donation. I don't really care. That's really not the attitude I want to bring to the table. So if you're like that about it, fine. Cool. Maybe don't support the next one then. But I know I've got people who will be understanding. I just don't want people to have that. Even like the chance to say that to me, you know? So I really appreciate you guys, and really, I love fucking talking to you guys. I've never, ever had this much fun doing streaming, ever in my life. And you guys make it fun every fucking time. Almost too much fun. I'm almost having too much fun here because I'm fucking distracted. So we will have some victorious focusing times while the stream is going, and you can, like, kind of dip in and out, check out other streams, do whatever you want, come back, you know, see where we're at in a little bit, but, or you can stick around the whole time and just, you know, keep newcomers company. You guys are my peeps. I trust you to do the thing that you want to do and have a good time doing it. So that's all I want from you. Let's just keep the stream kind of nice and chill. And yeah, I've never been having so much fun doing this, guys. Really, I mean it. This is the most chaotic fucking thing I've ever fucking done in my entire life. I don't even know how else to kind of like express how wildly insane it is. 'Cause every decision kind of feels like it just came up very, very abruptly and suddenly out of nowhere, you know? Like, hey, Kickstarter! And Meredith actually said yes to their regret. But now we're Kickstartering, and it's fucking going well. And I've got you guys to thank for that. Chauncey sent me a message today about the campaign y'all are running for me, basically. Fucking sharing more than me. You guys are incredible. And I think this is the easiest way for me to, like, ignore you is if I just shower you with compliments. So I'm just going to keep doing that because I don't have to look at the screen to say nice things about you. So there you go. I think I'm working on a solution. You guys are so cool. Phil, last night, bringing, like, streamers and viewers from other streams into the stream. Fucking, just like an anime character jumping from the rooftop of buildings. Like, just being like, have you guys heard the news about Victor Alpi? Like, what the fuck? So crazy. Amazing. Like, crazy amazing. I'm not trying to call you guys crazy, but it is insane. Like, I never thought this is, like, the first time I'm doing this. And it's because I never thought that, you know, people, like, would be this way. about my stuff. You know, when you're an artist and you don't really like have the confidence to take that plunge, you kind of feel like you're doing it on your own. You know, the likes and the numbers, those are, you know, people using their thumbs for a second. It's not like real interaction, you know? You know, like talk to people and really like connect. Let them know that your story like means something and y'all fucking believe in me and shit. That's amazing. I'm gonna have to be like a zoo animal for a little bit. I think that's a healthier way of thinking about it. I'm just a zoo animal mode. You guys are at the aquarium, and I'm just a shark in a tank. You can't talk to me. You just gotta let me swim around and let me do my shark thing until I'm done. Robbie, y'all have Robbie to thank for the awesome idea to make a Discord server. I have a Discord server for myself. Like, the Humarks Discord server is a private one for me, where I keep all my notes and stuff. But, like, yeah, like, why not just use Discord to talk when we're not, like, streaming or, like, talking directly over a stream or something, you know? Plug potential stuff that we got, like not stuff, potential stuff that we got, but like if you went to the shop, guys, and you picked up a cool book, feel free to take a photo and send it to the Discord. You know, make some comic recommendations. I think that's really cool, and I will pass them along because we've got a good relationship with our local shop here, who is like incredible and wants to include a lot of local art and artists in the things that they do. And Meredith actually just spent a lot of Saturday behind a table at their shop for Free Comic Book Day signing books and selling mini comics and stuff. So, you know, it's pretty great stuff. Hashtag free the Humarks is got to be probably the most heartwarming hashtag I've ever seen in my life. You guys, like, make me cry with that shit.
Is the 12 minutes up? Shit. I needed a timer. Oh, you guys got an extra 2 minutes out of me. You scoundrels. You didn't even say anything. Oh, I guess. Umbrella Miller, who else can I fit in here? Yo, hey, actually, yeah, good point. Thank you for bringing that up. Chauncey, I don't know if you're still listening, but that Gwen piece, man. Holy shit, dude. You crushed it. Crushed it. It looks fantastic. You're working in the background there. I have one recommendation. Just a recommendation. I love the piece. When you're doing, like, those elements in the background, like, the city looks great. But the moon, when you're doing like those really heavy, like kind of framing elements, bust out like a guide, like either a circle template, get a can, a cup, and just use the edge of it to get that circle in. It's gonna make your image just feel more powerful. It's kind of hard to explain, but the shape being kind of solid and like, a strong shape. That's why Tom Lyle did that. It wasn't like he didn't like make big moons for the hell of it, and he didn't make them like globby. It was a giant fucking circle, and that's why it's such a powerful image. It doesn't make any sense, and it literally is like a Tom Lyle thing, but he made it work. And I bet you he used a guide. But that's all, dude. Like, literally, you could still fix that. Fix it for yourself. Post a repost. Like, don't even take down the old one. Just be like, hey, I fixed that thing. Boom. I've done that once before. If you go back on my account, we were at a con once. And I was drawing in someone's sketchbook. I drew a Ryu drawing. Like, Ryu from Street Fighter. And I didn't draw the knot. And the belt hanging, his black belt. I drew like the belt part, but not the knot and the part that hangs. So it just looked like a solid black belt with no wrap or anything. And I was like, I play Ryu in every single fucking fighting game. And I forgot to draw that shit.
So I like went back and hunted it down. Like the guy who had the sketchbook, I realized like later, after he had already taken it from me, that I had forgotten to finish drawing his bell. So I had to like hunt him down for the book, and I was like, dude, I'm so sorry to do this, but I need to fix something in your book. I'm not letting you walk away with like my art not being finished. And I fixed that shit, and I posted it on Instagram twice, like on two different posts. I was like, hey, I fixed that thing that you guys probably didn't even notice the first time, but I did. But yeah, man, I think that image looks so fucking good, dude. You did such a great job. Proud of you, man. Like, you're drawing every day, and I see you getting better every day. It's incredible. Anyway, y'all. Yeah, hey, Robbie's back. I didn't even see. I can't sleep, so I'm back. Oh no, Robbie, I'm sorry. I'm leaving, dude. We gotta go eat food. But we're coming back for a later stream. But dude, you're like it's like 2 in the morning for you or something now, right? 2:30? It's really hard for me to see the chat sometimes. Oh, it's 1 a.m. Okay, guys. Okay, Robbie. Well, I was saying earlier, I was telling these guys they have you to thank for the Discord idea. So thank you for that, bud. It's really great. It's a good idea. I'm gonna like organize the channels and stuff, figure out all of you guys are probably gonna be like able to admin and stuff once there are people there to kind of regulate and stuff. So, you know, there's just no foul stuff going on. I don't care if people curse, but like, I don't want any bigot shit. But I just wanted to open it up and get it started so that you guys can join in and we'll fix it up when I've got more time down the line, like after the campaign and all. I'm gonna eat with Meredith. We're gonna chill for a little bit and then I'm coming back to work real fucking hard for the rest of the night. I'm probably gonna have to mute my mic and ignore you guys for a little bit, and then maybe when I take a break, I'll come check the chat. But I gotta draw, guys. I gotta get it done. Otherwise, I just am gonna have to start working off camera, and I don't wanna do that. I wanna hang out with you. So, anyway, see you in like an hour, maybe two. No one's gonna call you a poo-poo head on my watch, dude. Don't even think about it. All right, y'all. I'll catch you later. I'm gonna call it right here, and then we'll be back. Bye.